My dear viewers, we have Dr. V. Sridevi with us. I'm going to ask Dr. Sridevi, Doctor, can you share something about vomiting in pregnancy?
Yeah, thank you. So vomiting in pregnancy, usually we call it morning sickness because it usually occurs in the morning. So they may have about maybe 2 to 3 times in a day. And some people may have just nausea, that is the sensation to feel like vomiting but not vomiting. And why does it occur in pregnancy is because of the hormone beta HCG. So when that hormone increases, the vomiting usually occurs. And it starts from around 4 to 6 weeks and maybe up to 12 to 16 weeks. But it varies from person to person. Some people may have it till term. It is usually not to be worried about. Then how can we avoid this is by eating like small meals, and maybe morning you can have some biscuit or toast that will reduce the vomiting. And immediately after eating we should not lie down flat, so maybe after half an hour or 1 hour. And also anything that, like for some people, the smell of rice, they might have a stimulant towards that. So that should be avoided. And any fatty or oily foods should be avoided. So you can reduce the frequency of morning sickness, that's vomiting in pregnancy.
Yes, doctor. If it is excessive, some people they have excessive vomiting. And what you call actually, and can you share some knowledge about it, please?
Yeah, some people, so morning sickness, it need not be worried, but when it's excessive, so how do you know it's excessive? It's called as hyperemesis gravidarum. So when it's excessive means the frequency is very much increased. That's maybe about maybe 8 to 12 times in a day. And they cannot take any food, including liquids. Even a glass of water can bring it out. So like no food can be retained inside. And the regular normal activities cannot be done. They feel very tired, they feel very weak. And because they cannot take even liquids, the urine output itself will be reduced. And so these are the few symptoms which may have in hyperemesis. So when you have hyperemesis, that is excessive vomiting, you surely must go to the hospital. And there we do a few tests. We want to know, because what happens when there's excessive vomiting is the body loses the fluid and the salt. So because of that, they may go for acidosis. That's why we are ketosis and acidosis. That's why we are worried about this condition. And you go to the hospital, they will take your urine and check for urine ketones. And if that's positive, you have to be hospitalized. And they wouldn't give you anything in the mouth. It has to be, you have to be on intravenous fluids should be given. And there might be electrolyte balance as imbalance, as I already told you, water as well as the salts go out. So we treat them with IV fluid, intravenous fluids, and also the electrolytes should be corrected. And sometimes multivitamins also are given. And we don't want it to progress any further and go into any complications. So hyperemesis can be avoided, like when detected earlier itself.
Yeah, can you say what are the drugs they give, any drugs, yeah, what are the drugs they suggest?
Yeah, surely. So, there's nothing to be very much worried about, like, because we already told not to take much drugs, but hyperemesis might cause more complications. So, it's better to be on drugs. So, usually we start with antiemetics, and if it is in the stage before hyperemesis, you can give doxycycline, which is a tablet. And if it goes into hyperemesis, as I said, they cannot take even a glass of water. So that time, then we need to go for intravenous drugs like antiemetics like ondansetron, or the second line of drugs that can be given along with the fluids. And how do you know that they have improved is they will have a sense of well-being. They will be able to tolerate oral food. The urine output will be increased. So these are the signs to say it's increased. But what is the actual problem in this is the glucose starts getting utilized. So usually the glucose utilized, no problem. Now since there's no glucose because you're not able to eat anything, what happens is the body starts taking up the fats. So that is when we call this as the ketosis. and that's very dangerous, so we shouldn't allow it to that level. Initially, it can be treated at home.
Yeah, and one more, actually probably they will do the investigation of serum electrolytes also.
Serum electrolytes, and also we do urea, creatinine also, because we want to know that one. And we see for the random blood sugar and also for the urine ketones.
I do remember when the patient shift herself from home to the hospital or shifting of the environment, many times it helps.
Yes, they say it to have even neurotic or psychotic reason. So maybe a different place or a different situation or a different environment, like you change the food type or the environment, it may help.
Yeah, another one more thing, which are the patients will have more of excessive? Can you throw some light on this?
Yeah, sure. So as we already said, it's because of beta HCG. So any condition which has increased beta HCG. So the main, the first reason we can think of is in multiple pregnancy, that is in twins or in triplets. And also some people may be sensitive. They might have a sensitivity to increased beta HCG. And a condition called as vesicular mole, there also the beta HCG is increased. So they will also have excessive vomiting.
Yeah, that vesicular mole or heredity from mole is some grape-like structure.
Yes.
It's a cystic degeneration of the chorionic villi. That normally produces more of human chorionic gonadotrophy. Yeah, as told by Dr. Sridevi, it can be very easily correctable. And if it is hyperemesis, they have to go to the hospital. Because one of the main issues, as she said, is a ketosis. Yeah? And we are really thankful to the audience and thankful to Dr. Sridevi also.
Thank you.
Thank you.